Okay, there's an update on my camera boom. This is the small camera boom mounted with the Cannon FS27. The camera that's taking this video is also an FS37. Yes, I do have two of them. I decided to go with Servo to give them a try. These cameras are quite lightweight, so they don't need a lot of energy to move things about. And as you can see on there, I've got one servo on the side and one servo on the top. The top one's for pan and the bottom one for tilt. There's no zoom control on this system apart from manually on the camera. To mount the servos, basically it's just a frame of aluminium strip, and I've allowed enough room there, as you can see inside, for a coupling. The coupling itself is one of the horns, but what I've done, I've actually got the metal horns. This is a plastic one that's supplied with the kit. There's usually a two-way and a four-way at least supplied, but I've gone for metal supports. And what you do is you mount that on the side of the aluminium frame on the inside. That one there, so that the spline end is sticking out. There's a screw through the horn to hold it in position. There's also a screw drilled through the centre that lines up with the servo shaft. And once you've attached this, you put a screw through the middle into the servo, and that holds it quite rigid. The other side is just a bolt through with a nut between, just as a spacer, to hold a bolt in place, of course. And as you can see, as long as you don't wrench it around quickly, you can actually turn these servos. These are fairly heavy duty. I'll give you the numbers in the description of what the servos are, but yeah, any reasonable metal geared sort of heavy duty servo will do this job. And I'll show you in action in a moment. Cables come up, connect onto the side, and that then goes down the shaft of the camera boom. Now I'll show you the other end. Okay, this is the other end. What I've decided to do on this one is to make it instinctive control. The top one is pan, and there's control on the side for tilt. The electronics are actually in a plastic box, which is simply two 555 timers, one for each servo, and it's just adjusting the mark space ratio on these controls. Pretty basic, but it works. I plug the battery in so you can actually see the system working. The battery's in now, and look at the top end. The good thing about using servos, you can go quickly to the next position, or you can go quite slowly. Try and get the view of the monitor I use and the other end in view at the same time, so you can see what's happening. And you see on the little monitor, okay, I hope you caught all that. There will be a short video on the end of this showing the view from the camera on the boom. Currently showing my monitors, computer monitor, that's the multi-function monitor. CD collection. For those who remember tapes, there's a tape collection. and video collection. And because these controls are intuitive, you basically hold the knob still, move the arm, and it more or less stays in position. Looking down to the LP collection, I mean singles collection. Okay, there you go, that's the small boom in operation. Thanks for watching.